What's up? What's up? What's up? The show that took an hour to get going. What's up? Well, welcome to the Cone Zone. I am too far back. I am Axl Cones. Welcome to the show tonight. I want to get right into it because I don't want to miss a word out of my guest tonight. Tonight, we're going to discuss what women want. Forgive me, but I have to throw my two cents in here. What women want. No, I'm not going to talk about that gay Mel Gibson flick. But since I'm on the subject... Okay.
Waiting for stuff to be thrown at you?
Yeah, I'm gonna... Okay. But since I'm on the subject, if I could hear women's thoughts, screw Helen Hunt. I'd be on the first plane to the Sports Illustrated swimsuit photo issue. What the hell does that say? No.
You'd have issues.
I have issues with this, with that sentence. That just doesn't make any sense.
I did.
Okay, we'll try that again. If I could hear women's thoughts, I'd be on the first plane to the Sports Illustrated swimsuit photo shoot. There we go. Or even better, the Playboy Mansion. It's a lot funnier when I don't, you know, screw it up. If I had an inside track on what women wanted, Denise Richards would have herself a long-haired, tattooed, Cato Kalin-like pool boy. Yes. So what do women want? I'm starting to believe other women. As for me, I have no friggin' clue what women want. Christ, I've gone out with... With what? Okay. I've gone out with women who've taken 10 minutes figuring out what dressing they wanted on their dinner salad. Now, being male, for so long I thought women wanted to be treated with respect and kindness, to be loved unconditionally, to have someone who they could carry a conversation with, someone who they could go out with and have fun with, someone who will listen to them, someone to give them their space when they need it, to be given their freedom to do things with their friends. Well, guess what? I'm wrong. I gave all that to my ex, only to be dumped like a buttload of diarrhea after a 2 a.m. Taco Bell run. So what do women want? I'm starting to think women want a species of Peter Forsbergs with unspendable bank accounts and who are packing Tommy Lee-like Docker sausage.
What's so bad about that?
I'm right. Okay, end of monologue. I realize every woman is different, but I think the main companionship goal should be the same. Be with somebody who treats you well. Am I wrong? And hey, if you want to be treated like Tonya Harding, that's your business. I'm sure you won't have to look hard to find a guy out there who will slap you around while in his drunken rage because you went out with your friends instead of having his meatloaf ready when he came home smelling of prostitute sex.
Yeah.
Welcome to the show. You think I'm out of line. You think, that would never happen. Well, I know a woman whose husband was such a dick, Beelzebub was his poker buddy. He wouldn't let his wife cut her hair, wear makeup, read newspapers, listen to the radio, watch television, shave her armpits, talk on the telephone. When she wore dresses, they had to be below her ankles, and when she showered, she had to make her own soap. Sir, there you go, ladies. Think about being in that relationship the next time you want to break up with your husband or boyfriend because he was 10 minutes late for dinner at your parents' house. My advice to all the women watching this show, if you have a good guy, you better hang on to him. Because decent guys are about as rare as a cocaine addict steak in a restaurant. Some of you are laughing a little too hard at that joke. Don't take what you have for granted. And that greener grass that you think is on the other side is a poison ivy mirage of alcoholic, pathological lying, drug abusing, mental midget losers. Actually, you want to know who I blame for so many women who have more issues than Anne Heche? Those girly mags like Cosmo. Ladies, quit reading these magazines. These magazines don't want to see your relationship succeed, because if you were happy, you wouldn't continue to spend $4 an issue for crap advice like, if your man won't take the night off to cook you a 5-course candlelit dinner and then proceeds to make love to you for 4 hours as he tells you he loves you 30 times, dump him, you can do better. The publishers of these rags, so to speak, are bulldog dyke man-haters who have framed velvet pictures of Lorena Bobbitt in their living rooms. And oh yeah, don't put a lot of stock into those dumbass surveys that these mags want you and your significant other to take. Every time I'm asked the Cosmo question, when you're making love to your girlfriend or wife, who are you fantasizing about? I have to fake a seizure because according to Cosmo, whatever answer I give will be wrong. People ask me all the time, what am I looking for in a woman? It's not up to me. Because as long as there's PMS and women out there who change their mind more often than a Kotex on heavy flow days, women will rule the roost and men will have to go by their rules. That is, if they want to continue to get any. I think I can speak for every guy. As far as what women want, you have to tell us, ladies, okay? We're not mind readers. We're not Cognac the Great who can solve your female Rubik's Cube puzzle every minute of the day. If you're pissed off about something, if you want something, if you don't want something, here's an idea. Say it. Communication is a pretty easy concept to grasp. And no, communication isn't folding your arms and saying, whatever. FYI, if I wanted to talk to something without receiving an answer back, I'd talk to your vagina and cut out the middleman, okay? That's my take, but then again, I'm getting the couch tonight. Yeah. Tonight, we're going to do something a little different. As everybody knows, I do a lot for local music here in Denver, Colorado. Tonight, we're going to talk to the better halves of some of these rock stars here in Denver, Colorado. Would you help me welcome Char, Kristen, and Mikalia? Yeah. Yeah. What is up? What is up? Before we go any steak? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Before we go any further, who are your husbands?
Romero from Sick.
Romero from Sick. Good guy.
Uncle Nasty.
Uncle Nasty. Beautiful. Yeah.
Bill Terrell.
Rogue. Bill Terrell from Rogue. Very nice. Your husbands are the greatest, I gotta tell you right now. Yeah. Last week we had Romero and Uncle Nasty on the show.
Yeah.
So now we're gonna get your sides. We're gonna get a little even with the guys tonight. I feel so feminine right now. How did you guys meet your husbands?
Actually, it was at Bengals.
The nightclub.
Yeah, actually we've known each other just about our entire life.
Really?
Yeah.
How long have you guys been married?
I'm going on 10 years.
Oh, congratulations. Wow. Very cool.
Thanks.
I'll tell you what. You find me a couple nowadays that's been married 10 weeks, you
right,
know, without
right.
running to strangle each other.
Yeah.
We strangle each other.
Oh, you strangle each other. Very nice.
No. Actually,
we just talked about
it. Is that why he wears sunglasses right. in a dark room?
I was looking for him before I came into the room here and
couldn't see him.
He has him.
He has him. He wore them last week on the show.
Yeah.
Sorry, we won't hold that against him. He's still a good guy. How did you meet Uncle Nasty? So would you be your Aunt Nasty then? Is that the game?
Yeah, that's me. Aunt Nasty. Greg and I met at Bengals too.
Real? I'm telling you, Bengals. If you live in Denver, Colorado, if you don't remember Bengals, you're under a rock.
Yeah.
That was incredible. So how long have you guys been married now?
5 years.
5 years.
Yeah.
And you have like how many? You have four kids.
We have four kids.
Wow.
And
she still looks that good.
Know,
I'm telling you, that's
beautiful.
Awesome.
Thanks.
And you just had a baby recently, too.
He'll be three. He'll be three.
Okay, so not recently.
Yeah. Not real recently.
Who did my notes? So you just have one child with Uncle Nasty?
Yeah, just one.
And is he baby nasty?
He's definitely nasty. He has the nasty blood in him.
Nice.
No doubt about it.
And I actually went to your wedding, you and Bill's wedding. So you guys have been married almost a year now.
Yeah.
And you've got one in the oven.
I know.
Yeah, I know. It's gonna kill me when it's boring because I had you guys sitting in these heat lamps for a half hour.
He's gonna come out a little egg McMuffin.
He is. I'm ready, Mom. Turn over.
Yeah.
But well, cool. How do you like marriage? Since you're a newlywed there.
Well, I want to know how she met Bill.
Oh, that's true. How did you meet Bill? I know the story, so I guess I didn't. I don't care. No, I'm just kidding. How did you meet Mr. Terrell?
I met
at Bangles.
When he was on tour, actually.
When he was on tour with Rose?
Yeah, in Indiana.
So you're from Indiana?
And so is he, yeah.
Oh, really?
From the same town.
Very nice. What part of Indiana?
Terre Haute.
Oh, very cool.
Hey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very cool. So how long did you guys date before you got married?
We didn't.
Very nice.
I don't consider any of the times a date.
I don't know why that struck me so funny. All right, well, moving right along. So you guys are all of your husbands are singers in bands.
Oh.
Are they as prissy as they appear?
And more.
And more?
Yes.
Do they appear prissy?
Yeah, they appear. Lead singers to me, I've followed music since I was in the womb. And lead singers just have that, you know, I have to have it right now kind of thing. Are you guys pretty much like that?
Yeah, I think that's
as they're in the back, they're gonna throw a chair up here in a second.
Yeah, I think that you know, you have to have that quality in you to be able to perform on stage.
Right. Mm-hmm. So now we can edit out that dull time. So now Romero wears makeup on stage. Oh, do you help him with that?
Actually, I do hair. He does makeup. I'm trying to teach him the hair stuff because he's going to LA here in a couple weeks.
That's what I hear.
He needs to start doing it himself.
He's got the Nikki Six look happening.
Yeah, it does. I think it looks great.
It does.
That's good.
Shout out the devil.
Shout out the devil. That's right. So I was going to ask you this. I ask all the bands that come in about groupies. Now, before I got a recent girlfriend, I was getting groupies out the ass because I was single. What do you guys feel? Not that that's a bad thing. Come on, I'm a celebrity here. Come on. What do you? How do you guys fend off groupies? We went to Saw Sick over at the at Alice Cooper's town.
Right.
And one of my girlfriend's friends. It was Halloween night.
Right.
And those of you who know the story, who follow Sick, know the story. This naked woman was on stage. I mean, she was like butt naked. She had these little bats painted on her nipples.
And I didn't hear it that.
She somebody's got the couch tonight. I mean, no, she had clothes on. Sorry, man, I didn't mean to get your cut off. She walked behind Pat, one of the guitar players for Sick, and she put her arms around him, and his girlfriend was standing front row. She took this drumstick and just whacked her. I mean, hard. Yeah, well, how do you guys feel about that? Because you all have good-looking husbands. How do you feel with groupies? Do they know not to approach them?
No, they may know it, but they don't follow their better judgment. Mm-hmm. I'm sure.
When the alcohol kicks in, it's all free for all.
Yeah, in their own heads, I guess.
So
yeah.
Do you guys go out to a lot of the shows? Do you see a lot of this happening?
Sure.
And how do you react to something like that? You just kind of let it say, hey, as long as he comes home to me, that's all good.
That's exactly it.
Right.
You know, at
Pretty
the end
much.
Of the day, I know where his head is, you know,
so
what pillow it's at. Yeah, absolutely. It has to be there. That trust factor needs to be there. And if it doesn't, then I'm wasting my time and he's wasting his.
And right. And that's very cool.
Yeah.
That's very cool.
Very, very eloquent.
Yeah, look at you. Mikalia's so cute. So how long are you? How far are you along now?
I have 7.5 weeks left.
7.5 weeks. I was hoping she'd give birth on stage. Damn it! That's an Emmy
waiting
to happen.
You're not cutting it close.
Yeah.
So do you guys go on the road with your husbands? Do you kind of stay home and when they're on the road in other cities?
I have, but with children, it's difficult.
Right.
You can't always get mom to come stay for a week.
Which girl?
Mm-hmm. And she sells it, I bet. There's been a couple occasions that I've had the opportunity to fly to L.A. and watch him, so.
Well, very cool. And Bill Terrell right now is in San Francisco, right?
Right.
He's doing his CD.
Mastering.
That's so cool. God, I love that. That's awesome. Denver's breaking through. I know it is. Well, very cool. Have you heard any of the new stuff yet? Did he send you a copy yet?
Yeah, I think
does he sing it in the
really
shower?
Good.
That's what I was going to ask you here in a second.
I hear it all the time.
Right.
And every time I hear it, it's still as good as it was the first time.
Right.
I heard it. And I think he's very talented. And
all those guys in Rogue are very talented. Johnny, EA, all of them. They're huge.
Yeah.
So do your guys sing in the shower? And in front of mirrors and crap with brushes?
Yeah, but my husband sings opera.
Does he really?
What the hell is that about? Are you serious?
Entirely.
Uncle
serious.
Pavarotti. That's a new name. Hey. Beautiful. I'm going to call KPI Monday. Hey, Uncle Pavarotti, I need to hear a song.
No, it's because he, you know, vocally, it enhances, you know, his performance on stage if he's able to do the range of the scales, you know. So he does the scales like a professional. Mm-hmm. See?
Very
cool. How that works?
My husband
and
does
yours?
The same
thing.
No, she does the same thing.
Yeah,
wow.
See, so it's
yeah.
Right.
Chris doesn't sing, but he takes a long time in there.
Really? So I take it after four kids. He's already been cut off. Is that why he's been cut off?
No.
Is there something dripping from your walls that we need to know about in there?
Oh.
No.
Hey, it's an adult show. Get off. Come on.
That's great.
Anyway,
he really doesn't.
He doesn't what?
He really doesn't sing, and at least I am at work, so I don't hear him.
Right. So, and that was, you guys are just falling right into my role here. What do you guys do as far as, do you have jobs, or do you, what do you all do for a living?
I do have a job. I'm a vice president for purchasing product management for a food distribution company.
Oh, very cool. Very cool.
Wow.
Nice. Vice president on stage. What's happening?
Hey, thanks.
I feel so low on the food rung here. And Kristen, what do you do?
I'm fortunate. I stay home with my 3-year-old, and I make jewelry, and I do mosaics, and I do a lot of art stuff that I hope to make money with someday.
Oh, very good.
Bracelet?
Bracelet? Yeah, my bracelet.
But I show that off. Can we get a shot of that? Look at that.
Okay.
There
we go.
Cool. So what's up?
No, but
I
have to do.
Yeah, hey, I've turned into Joan friggin' Rivers up here. What the hell is this about? What would something like that go for?
Well, this is made with smoky quartz, garnet, and carnelian, so it'd probably be upwards of, I'd say about $40 or $50.
Oh, well, that's cool.
Yeah, and semi-precious stones. But someday I'd like to do walls and floors, mosaics.
Like paintings?
No, like tile.
Oh, tile. Oh, very cool.
Yeah, with tile.
Mosaics.
Mosaics.
I've been under these lamps for 2 hours. Jesus.
Not mural.
I don't know my name right now.
Yeah.
Very cool. Mikalia, I know you're kind of not doing much right now because of...
I work part-time.
What do you do?
I'm a sales associate at Petco. Part-time, but the rest of my time goes straight to my husband.
Right.
He needs it.
Right. He needs it. You're on a roll tonight, darling. You're on a roll. So Bill Terrell got signed.
Yeah.
So are you just, you can't sleep at night, I bet, huh?
Oh, I sleep.
Metaphorically speaking.
But that's why I can sleep.
That's right.
Yeah.
6 months, I don't have to work anymore. Fuck yeah! So beautiful. Beautiful. And I'm not just, I'm like not kissing ass or anything, but you guys are next. So get ready.
Yep.
Oh.
We've been
Six got a showcase in L.A. coming up. Who are they showcasing for? Do you know?
She's going to kill me.
Shout it up here if you're out in the crust. Oh, there he is.
Warner Brothers. And there's going to be several people driving up here. He was talking to The guys from Warren to Jerry Dixon.
Jerry Dixon.
Yeah, and all those guys are going to be heading out there. Ton of people.
Jerry Dixon, for those of you who don't know, is from a band called Warren.
Cherry Pie.
Cherry Pie. We're going way back. So does Uncle Nasty have anything coming up here soon? I hear he had something wrong with his throat, but that's all taken care of now? It's all
well,
good?
With time. Oh, yeah, he's doing an independent, locally written and produced movie called Some Kind of Woman.
Strange
Kind of Woman.
Some Kind of Strange
Woman.
Sounds like a porno.
You know, it's interesting. I saw in one of your other shows, the character that Greg plays ran into like a renegade proctologist, and he sells celebrity stools on the internet, and I saw
all right.
And it reminded me of something you did on another show that I saw.
Beautiful. How much would a carrot top stool go
I'm
for?
I'm not sure.
I'm just curious.
I haven't gotten that far. Yeah, so that'll be out sometime next year.
The stool or the movie? I'm just kidding. Come on. We got to lighten up here a little bit.
Yeah, but his voice will be better.
Very cool.
He needs some rest, and he needs to be real good to himself, and he'll be just fine.
Mm-hmm. I'm not kissing his ass or anything, but Uncle Nasty has done more for local talent. Romero said it best last week. Mm-hmm. He has done more for local talent than anybody I've ever seen in this city. And everybody in the business, whether it's television or music or whatever, owes him a huge, huge gratitude.
Nice, sir. It's nice to be back.
That's right.
It's really nice to be back.
Yeah. It is very, very cool. Very cool. I remember, and Uncle Nasty, close your ears. I think Willie B's a fag.
Well,
personally.
Okay.
But that's just me. Everybody. I've gotten into it with him a couple times. So, yeah. We'll cut the censor there. But.
You're making friends tonight.
Hey, you know. Uncle Nasty rules. The other guys, you know, screw it. Have you heard the locker room show?
Oh, I've heard it. Ugh. But we shouldn't talk about this.
We'll talk about something else. I'll bring that topic up next month.
Yeah.
Anyway.
But Willie on your show.
That's right.
Yeah. Beautiful. I don't know if I could keep a straight face. You know, he's good at what he does. But throwing a chicken
They're
off a roof,
different.
Get a fucking
They have
grip.
Very different styles, and many, many people are huge fans of Willie, and you know.
Yeah.
Many, many people who like Nasty don't like Willie, and but you know they're good friends. Willie's a really great guy, and you know.
He's just done a few things to some of the local bands that I don't really care about.
I know, I'm sure.
But anyway, let's not talk about that anymore.
Let's not.
Let's bring up something.
Talk about us.
That's right. Let's talk about us.
Yeah.
What do women want? We got a couple minutes left. What do women want? Look at that.
You talked about it a few minutes ago. There was a sausage, Tommy Lee.
How's Romero? How's Romero packing? Is he
pretty
good?
He's got four kids.
He's got four kids. Yeah, so hey, do the math.
He packs.
He packs pretty good. Oh, very nice. Why the hell did I ask that? What am I stirring all of a sudden? What the hell? So you're into Johnson's. Very nice. Yeah. You know where we're headed. Kristen, what are you all looking?
Oh, I don't know. you know, life is.
Good for you, Romero. You prick.
He hasn't always been that person that he is now, but I knew that he was.
Ooh, let's delve into that a little bit
when
more.
What do you mean by that? Oh, people change through over time, you know, and people as time goes by, we learn.
He's always been a good guy. I've never had any problems.
He's a great guy.
He's awesome.
He's
always been good to me.
Good.
So there's something you're not telling us.
Oh, well, no. I mean, he is nasty for a reason.
Okay, moving right along.
Don't take that too late.
I know. I meant it.
Very nice.
Both ways.
Mikalia, let's... What do you want? What do women want? What do you think women want? What do you want? Okay,
have this baby.
Everything.
You just got it. You got a child on the way, and your husband signed. I guess there's nothing more.
And he's packing too.
He's packing too. Yeah. We got some slinging Johnsons in this music scene here in Denver. How's Uncle Nasty? Is he?
Oh, he's up to par.
He's up to par.
Way above par.
Very nice. Yeah. Well, he's tall too. He's like what, 6'2"?
Yeah, 3.
6'3"?
Mm-hmm.
Very nice.
Very, very nice.
How do we get into this subject? I don't know.
What women
you
want.
You brought it up. You well, brought it up.
I did.
We're talking men's Johnsons up here. What the hell is this?
I feel so gay right now.
It's the Johnson zone.
It's the Johnson zone. On Denver Cable. You guys want to come up and sit with your wives?
Sure.
Come on up.
Oh.
Give it up. I'll be her husband
okay.
for right now.
Okay.
All right. Give it up. Charlotte, Kristen.
Thank you.
Mikalia.
Thank you,
Axl. Beautiful. Any parting shots you want to get off before we go to headlines?
To support Denver music scene.
Amen.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Amen. There's a lot of good bands out there.
Amen. Beautiful. All right. We'll get into some headlines. If you have a headline, send them to see Axl Cones, 1209 Pennsylvania, Suite E, Denver, Colorado.
80203.
Love that. God, you bring that out every week.
You gotta get them to come every show now.
I do. They gotta come out every show. It's just not gonna be the same. My zip code girls. My first headline reads, I gotta fly through these. Next week on Fox, bikini models and the hairdressers who masturbate to them.
He's all here.
Huh? I know, another masturbation joke. Go figure. Stephanie reminds herself never to go on a blind date again. Here we go. Come on, sweetie, just a couple more shots and I'll be supermodel Claudia Schiffer. I actually have two for this one. Doctors revealed this week that ex-model Heather Mills is actually a tripod. Or ex-model Heather Mills' husband David is jealous of Heather's third leg. Speaking of Johnsons, there we go. These we gotta get a little tied in on there. Where are we here? Those new Doc Johnson blow-up dolls look so realistic. All right, a couple of people got that one. All right, we got to zoom in really good on this one. See if we can get in real tight on that shot there. The Dixie Chicks were in Denver this week. Didn't know they were in the house tonight. Here we see Craig Titus, winner of this year's I Have No Penis contest. And finally, the cloning of Sally Struthers was a complete success. All right. I want to thank the Rockstar Wives. Get out there and check out the bands. Sick, a band called Horse, Rogue. Check them out. Check out all of Denver music. That is the show. Good night.